Hello everyone, I welcome you to my channel. Today I'm going to show you how to install WinSCP software in your industrial operating system. So, let's begin. Now, before installing WinSCP software, we need to first understand what this software basically does. WinSCP is basically a free and open source SSH file transfer protocol software using which you can copy your files related to your website to a server. So for that, we use basically this WinSCP software. In this video, I am going to show you how to install, and then I will also show you how to use this WinSCP. Now, to download WinSCP, you need to first simply go to your favorite browser, and in here just simply type WinSCP download, then enter. And then you will be seeing this www.winscp.net is basically our first search result. So you know, just simply click on this official site of download WinSCP. This will automatically redirect you to this official website of WinSCP. Now in here, if you just simply scroll down a bit, you'll be seeing this WinSCP 5.7 is basically our latest version. And here you'll be seeing this download button. So to download, just simply click on this download button. This will automatically going to start your download. As now you can clearly see that WinSCP is now currently downloading. I have already downloaded it, so just simply cancel it and then just simply minimize my browser. And if I simply go to my download directory, you can clearly see this WinSCP 5.17 version has been directly downloaded over here. And you can clearly see the file size is only 10.6 MB. Now to install WinSCP, just simply double click on it. And then I'm just simply going to minimize my download directory. And in here, you can clearly see that WinSCP setup installer wizard has been rightly open, and it's now currently telling that whether we'd like to install for all users, which is recommended. So for that, just simply click on that. And then after giving administrative privileges, you'll be seeing this WinSCP license agreement. So this is the license agreement. If you have some time, then you can read that. But for now, I'm just simply going to accept this license agreement. And now it's telling that whether we'd like to typical installation or custom installation. So for which you can clearly see that typical installation is recommended. So just simply keep this all default and then just simply click on next. And now it's asking which interface we'd like to use. So one is this Commander, another is this Explorer. So I'd recommend Commander. So for that, simply check this Commander and then just simply click on next. And then just simply click on install. So this will automatically going to start your installation. It is just a 10 MB file, so it will going to install at a rapid pace. So now that you can clearly see that WinSCP setup wizard has been rightly installed, so just simply click on finish to simply launch our WinSCP. And now you can clearly see that they have redirected you to a browser telling that thanks for installing WinSCP, and they have given some instructions about how to use WinSCP, so you can read that. I'm just simply going to give you an overview about how to use WinSCP. So here in the taskbar, as you can clearly see that this WinSCP has been rightly opened, and our desktop icon of WinSCP has also been created. So to open WinSCP, just simply click on this desktop icon, and now it's saying that to insert this host name, then port number, then username and password. So in here you need to give the host name and then the port number and then the username and password, and after that you can also simply click on save to save that username and later when you are again trying to log in, then you need to just simply give this only password. And after giving all these credentials, you will be seeing this login option has been activated. So you need to then simply click on login, and then you will be able to see your directory right at the right side. So in there, you need to just simply drag and drop your files that you want to simply host. So in this way, you install WinSCP, and then I have given you a simple overview of how to use WinSCP. So that's all for this video, friends. I have this website called geekyscape.com. So do check our website geekyscape.com. In here, you'll be seeing various tutorials along with some blogs that I have written. If you still have some issues, then you can always follow this WinSCP documentation. Using this, you'll be able to use WinSCP without any problem. So that's all for this video, friends. Thank you very much for watching this video. If you like this video, then please give it a like and also do share it with your friends. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.